Lagombi is a fanged beast introduced in Monster Hunter Portable 3rd. He resembles a rabbit with two large ears. He usually stands upright and has a body structure similar to that of Azura's. He can be found living in Arctic regions and is usually encountered early in the games he appears in. Lagombi shares a lot of attacks with Azura's. He can swipe in different directions, charge backwards, and perform the occasional tackle. The biggest way Lagombi differs is his ability to slide along the ice. He uses his back legs to push himself forward and slide towards you in different attacks. He can slide forwards or in a donut. When enraged, he will slide at you, turn around, and immediately slide again. He can even do it up to 3 times. He has other attacks not shared with Azura's, such as being able to throw icy rocks at you. These simple changes make Lagombi a decent beginner monster. While he has many similarities to Azura's, the sliding is enough to make him feel very different. It adds a huge layer of unpredictability to the fight. If he slides at you, it is often hard to tell when he will do it again, and on rare occasions he will even do it an additional time. It keeps you on edge and makes you careful not to face him head on, as he can cover distance very easily. With Azura's, you could stay just out of reach and be safe from his attacks, but because of Lagombi's sliding, either to the side or his front, and his ice projectiles, you have to be a bit more careful. Lagombi shows up in Monster Hunter 3 Ultimate. He has a faster rate of attack in G rank, but now he can roll a giant snowball at you that steadily increases in size. If you come into contact with it, you'll be inflicted with Snowman. Unlike Azura's, Lagombi was in Monster Hunter 4 and Ultimate. He shared a theme with Azura's in Portable 3rd and 3 Ultimate, but in this game, he shares a theme with the weaker monsters. For Ultimate, Lagombi has a new attack where he jumps up into the air, lands on his bottom, and rolls around. As a side effect of Azura's not being in this game, Lagombi gains his multi-swipe attack. His initial landing causes tremors, and his rolls knock you onto the floor. He can also use his ice projectiles in different ways, like throwing them at a shorter range. Lagombi also appears in Generations, being unchanged from his 4 Ultimate version, except for the fact he has his old theme back. Like Azura's, Lagombi also gets a deviant in this game, the Snow Baron Lagombi. Snow Baron has darker fur, a more purple belly, different shaped ears, and longer fur growing on his arms. In terms of combat, he differs from the standard Lagombi by having enhanced ice throwing abilities. The ice rocks he throws are bigger, and he can throw more of them at once. He also has other enhanced abilities. For example, being near Lagombi as he slides through the ice is enough to inflict Snowman in some cases. His signature attack has him lift a snowball like in 3 Ultimate, but instead of rolling it immediately, Snow Baron will pick it up and chuck it at you, causing it to explode into smaller ice fragments. In later Deviant fights, he will throw giant snowballs that stay on the ground and explode. If he's enraged, he will manually push them away after a delay, causing them to roll along. His sliding and jump attacks leave icy mist in the air that inflicts Snowman, and he has a new finisher attack that has him jump and land on his back. Lagombi returned for Monster Hunter Rise, once again being in a game alongside Azura's. He doesn't have his classic theme from Portable 3rd, instead using the theme of whatever area he's in. Lagombi in this game has all his attacks from 4 Ultimate, including the big jump, the giant snowball, and the various different slides, but he has a higher rate of attack, making the fight quite a bit faster paced. When he throws ice chunks that land on the ground, they form snow puddles that restrict your movement. Getting hit by the giant snowball won't inflict Snowman anymore, due to its removal in the 5th generation. Sunbreak Lagombi has very few differences, but when enraged he becomes a lot faster. Not just his rate of attack, but things like his snowballs move at an incredible speed, and he chains them with other attacks. His smaller snowballs leave larger puddles too. Lagombi's mail armour looks like it's designed for Arctic expeditions. It features a large buttoned up coat lined with fur, with the helmet and boots designed to keep a hunter warm. The female set is also designed to counter cold weather with a similar appearance. Both sets have turquoise highlights that can be recoloured. The Snow Baron set looks similar, but are much darker in colour, with purple highlights that can be recoloured. The hats have nice little feathers in them. Lagombi's sets throughout the series have skills relating to evasion, which makes sense as Lagombi is a monster that can cover a lot of distance. The sets usually have environmental abilities, In 3 Ultimate, the set negates the snowman status, which would be very convenient considering what Lagombi is capable of. In 4 Ultimate, it cancels the cold entirely, meaning no need for hot drinks. Snow Baron's set is optimized for aerial style users, with stamina management and aerial attack boosting skills. An interesting choice for sure. Now, in terms of G-Rank set design, okay, so it turns out these are the only Lagombi designs. He only has one per gender, no gunner sets, throughout the entire series. Well, that was quicker than I was expecting. Moving on. Lagombi is a unique and fantastic starter monster. Despite heavily borrowing from Azora's, in terms of attacks and animations, he still manages to be very unique, and the sliding adds a whole layer of unpredictability to the fight, making it very dynamic. I don't particularly have a favourite Lagombi, I think they're all great, but if I had to pick one, it would probably be the Sunbreak iteration. It has a lot up its sleeve that I wouldn't expect, and has all the attacks introduced in 4 Ultimate. Snow Baron is an interesting deviant. The sliding is Lagombi's signature move, his most defining trait, but Snow Baron instead focuses on the ice throwing and ends up being very unique as a result. Which Lagombi is your favourite? Let me know in the comments below. Remember to like this video, subscribe to my channel, donate to me on Patreon, and have a good day.